The reality is that we are in a major transition, and that transition is happening right now. So we don't know exactly what the distribution landscape is going to look like, but we're working very hard to align ourselves with all the different companies that we work with.
How do you choose where and what distribution platforms you use for them? Because Roma, for example, was made as a narrative feature, did go out in some theaters, but was mainly a Netflix film. A lot of your movies, of course, are big theatrical releases worldwide. You work with studio releases, you work with independent releases. Is this that just a film-by-film decision, or is it changing quite fundamentally now that streamers, for example, are much more useful or impactful because you can get them to in front of a lot more eyes? How is that changing? How do you decide where, not just what films you want to make and what impact you want to make with them, but how you bring them out to which platforms you use?
Well, I personally believe that it's the job of the producer to live the life of the movie from its inception, from its development, through its financing and choice of distribution, through the way it's distributed and marketed. And that's really your job as the producer to do all of those things. And I guess in answer to your question, so that's what we seek to do at Participant. It's not a big company, it's not a tiny company, but we invest a lot of resources in making sure that our films are presented as appropriately as possible, but also in the most robust fashion possible. So we are super, super careful about how we position and place each of our movies with distributors. And as I said before, we see it as a partnership. We have the great luck that Jeff funds the company and allows us to spend not a huge amount of money, but a relevant amount of money on development. So we control almost all of our own development, which gives us a certain amount of control over how the film is ultimately sold to a distributor, or how we partner with a distributor. And we also co-finance movies as well, and so that gives us leverage as well. But we've been at this for 16, the company's been at this for 16 years, and it's developed, I think, a pretty good reputation for making very, very high quality material and being a good partner with people. And getting back to what I said at the beginning, it's interesting because the dynamic between artists, distributors, and impact organizations is a very complicated one. Artists and distributors are constantly trying to figure out what's the balance that they feel most comfortable between the two. And impact organizations have no experience working with artists and distributors. Yet, when you connect the three of them, you can create real scale around the work that we're seeking to do. So you can create scale by lots of people seeing your movie, and lots of people then, what we like to say, sort of engaging in the fourth act of the movie or the TV series, which is working with us in the impact space. And so it's a really dynamic but very complicated relationship, but one that distributors now are beginning to the more success that we have, are beginning to understand the value to, because distributors are commercially oriented companies, right? They're not nonprofits, right? They have to make money, they have to pay their staff, they have to stay in business. And we have a great appreciation for that, but they're beginning to understand the value of what it is that we do. They love the content that we create, it's done quite well over the years, but we're also engaging in an audience that they don't necessarily engage with. So it's their job to put butts in seats. We don't do that. We're not marketing films, right, to audiences. But we do engage, and I used this example when we spoke the other day. The Sierra Club was our partner on An Inconvenient Sequel. The Sierra Club has 2.5 million members in the United States. So you're speaking to them about something that's quite important to us, that's very important to them, because it sinks directly into the work that they're doing around climate change in the United States. And you're also making 2.5 million people very, very aware of something that we believe that they're going to enjoy as well, and will support their own activity and their own commitment, in this case, to climate change. So and then I'll answer your question, which is sort of answered your question. Typical David Linde. But it's your job to figure out what the best distribution is. But the reality is that we are in a major transition. And we talked a little bit about this yesterday, and that transition is happening right now. So we don't know exactly what the distribution landscape is going to look like, but we're working very hard to align ourselves with all the different companies that we work with. And we work with, you know, I don't know, 11 or 12 distribution companies probably every year at this rate. But we do see streaming as a real opportunity for our work, because so many people see the films, and you know exactly where it is, right? You don't have to go find it, and so we see that as a business that we can really align with. But we also align with theatrical distributors because we believe strongly in the theatrical world, and we also love the hybrid model. So.